I hope that you guys will find this very informative. The sheriff's budget is a very, very big part of a county budget. It's a very important position, and we need a good qualified candidate. And I think all three of these guys each have something unique to bring to the table. So with that, we're going to start with our prayer. Ralph?
This prayer was taken from a prayer said at the First Continental Congress, September the 7th, 1774, 9 o'clock in the morning. Please join me. Our Lord, our Heavenly Father, look down in mercy, we beseech thee. Be thou present, O God of wisdom, and direct the counsels of this honorable assembly. Enable them to settle things on the best and surest foundation, that order, harmony, and peace may be effectually restored. May truth and justice prevail and flourish amongst the people. All this we ask in the name and through the merits of Jesus Christ, thy Son and our Savior. And they all said,
Amen.
Amen. And if you'll stand up, we'll say the pledge. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, Steve. All right, gentlemen, you know, Steve mentioned you'll have a 5-minute introduction. A little bit more along the lines of housekeeping here. I will be keeping time. So as he mentioned, it's going to be a 2-minute limit on each question. At the minute 30 mark, I'll hold up a green card so that you know that you know where you are with time. And then at a minute 50, I'll hold up a red card. And finally, at 2 minutes, we'll ring the bell. So we ask that you keep the time limit so that we can keep things moving. Okay. I'm just going to go in the order that we have in here. So.
Good evening. I'm Laura McDonald III, and I want to be your sheriff of Forsyth County. I'm excited about this unique opportunity to run for sheriff, not as someone that has 25 years of law enforcement experience, but as someone who runs a business and manages people. You, the citizens, allow me this opportunity because anyone in this room could be doing what I'm doing today. The laws allow for ethical and moral people the opportunity because anyone could be running for sheriff. The people of Georgia could have empowered our legislature to change the law to only allow those that have law enforcement experience if they thought it would be best for the citizens of Georgia. Today, the law allows for a businessman to offer himself to manage an office that has a budget of over $38 million and a staff of over 370 deputies and other employees. I'm a third generation firefighter with both my grandfather as an assistant chief and my dad as a chief for 25 years. I am proud of my 24 years in public safety as a fireman and my 11 years as your coroner. Like many of you, I chose to move to Forsyth County and invest in my future in starting a successful business. My greatest accomplishment is my family. My wife Claire and I have 2 boys in Forsyth County school system, one in second grade and one in third grade. And we have a daughter who will start in 1 year. They are the big reason why I'm standing in front of you today. From my early years in scouting to an elected position by my peers as captain of Station 1 during the volunteer days of Forsyth County, my friends and colleagues have chosen me to lead them and make life-challenging decisions for the betterment of all involved. Since then, you have elected me 3 times as your coroner. In the past 11 years, I've learned a lot about the investigative science of death as coroner. I've experienced our traffic issues, not only because of congestion, but what happens when there is a wreck or fatality and the citizen sits stagnant on the road. I will have a plan. Over the past 15 years, Forsyth County has doubled in size. As the population was continuing, the Office of Sheriff's budget went in almost a vertical climb. It is now 41% of our total operating of our net budget of our $92 million. There are 41 other departments in Forsyth County that have to share the other 59%. As your sheriff, I promise to reduce the budget, but not the service and protection that should be provided to each one of you. A clear and transparent view of the budget and drug seizure funds will be available through a 9-member sheriff's council. This citizens group of men and women will assist in budget decision and personnel recommendations. This will in turn make for a more efficient office. This is going to be a priority. I want to work with our county manager and commissioners so that the reduction of the sheriff's budget could go to the reduction of debt in our county. As my first priority is the reduction of the overall budget of their office, the top priority is to ensure the safety of our 37,626 kids in our schools. With only 7 school resource officers working in our system, our children and our teachers are vulnerable. Our school system is paying half of the salaries of these officers to have our children and our teachers protected. The presence of our deputies is a deterrent for the possibilities of wrongdoing. Our deputies need to be role models for our kids and provide education about drugs, alcohol, gangs, and cyber crimes. Our drug seizure funds that exist should be infused in such programs instead of buying non-essential vehicles. I promise to increase the presence of the resource program to not only educate the kids, but the parents as well. Parents need to know what's going on in the cyber world, and the choices our children make today can affect their lives for eternity. It is the responsibility of the sheriff to protect these kids and teachers. I, along with the deputies, will work with our educators in Forsyth County to give these kids the best possible chance for success. A sheriff's office can only be as good as its deputies. A sheriff needs to be someone who has the mutual respect and trust of the deputies. I promise to work towards better pay for the deputies. A clear and defined career path will be established for both certified officers and non-certified as well. Retention of our deputies is going to be one of the most important things. We will keep a strong civil service section of the office and place some of the most knowledgeable deputies to complete these duties. The jail will not be a place for punishment for deputies, but a place that one will want to begin and finish his career. I will restore the feeling and pride of being a Forsyth County deputy and what the true meaning of protecting and serving is all about. It's time to bring the budget down and the morale up. To accomplish these goals, I'm going to need the trust of you, the citizens of Forsyth County. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Everybody hear me okay? Thank you. I'm Ted Paxton. It's been my honor and pleasure to be your sheriff for the last 11 plus years. Over those 11 years, it's correct, we have seen a tremendous amount of growth in population in Forsyth County. But we've also responded to that growth. We've been able, with the economic downturn over the last several years, to still maintain a tremendous impact on crime in Forsyth County. We've been able to drive crime down. Crime stats are down. We've been able, during that period of time, to bring to the forefront new technology never seen before in law enforcement in Forsyth County. From the time I took office to today, where we have come to in the availability of technology and what the deputies have at their fingertips out there in the field to be able to do their job. The creation of our own training division dedicated to make sure that we keep them on the cutting edge of everything that has to do with the effective enforcement of law in Forsyth County. Mr. McDonald's right. We do have a lot of programs just like he's talking about. Great programs. I agree with him. Yes, we do have deputies in the school system, and yes, they do pay for the salaries, and it's not 50%, it's 70%. That's how much they're in the schools. That's the trade-off that the school system wants. We work in conjunction with them. What type of presence, police presence, do they want in the schools? I'm not going to dictate it to them, but we're there to provide the level of service which they want. It's been my pleasure to serve you for the last 11 plus years. We still got a lot of work to do, a lot of things to do. I look forward to continue to serve as your sheriff. Remember this, bottom line, what does the sheriff do? He enforces the law. He serves the courts, and he operates the county jail. I stand on my record. I'm steadfastly proud of the record, what we have done here in Forsyth County, and I look forward to continue to serve you in this capacity. Thank y'all.
Thank you all for being here. I'd ask one thing of everybody in this room. Please maintain this level of interest in your local government and your local elections throughout this election cycle. Do exactly what we're doing here tonight. Come meet your candidates, get to know what they're about, what they'll do. Ask them questions, ask them hard questions. Are they running for office because they want to fulfill the constitutional imperatives of what the office is for? Or are they running for a political position? Hundreds of years ago, when the U.S. Constitution and our state constitution were written, it was written by men who were creating a government for two purposes: maintain order and to provide for the overall security of the people of the citizenry. Every position was created for a specific purpose. The office of sheriff is a constitutional position. It has some specific constitutional responsibilities. Are your candidates running for the reasons of fulfilling those responsibilities, or is it a political position? What happens when your government gets out of control? Your budget goes up. The budgets go up, taxes go up. Nothing good can come of that. We have several metro Atlanta areas where their budgets have gotten out of control: Gwinnett, DeKalb, Fulton. We have chaos. We have escalating taxes. Escalating taxes hurt every one of us. They don't hurt us all equally. There's groups of people, specifically people on fixed incomes, our senior citizens, and our disabled folks. You had 25, 50, $100 a month to their taxes, that impacts their life. Not their lifestyle, that impacts their life. That's not a couple times a month they can't go out to eat. That's groceries that they can't buy. That's medication that they won't be able to buy. I'm not gonna be a part of raising the taxes. Mr. McDonald did a good job of outlining a lot of the things I've been talking about for the last several months. The budget's got to be cut, but we cannot and we will not do that at the expense of the outstanding law enforcement the people in Forsyth County expect and deserve. We can actually improve what we're doing. We have an example of the east of us and the west of us, a couple of comparatives. Cherokee County and Hall County, both of them operate much larger agencies than we have. They have bigger jails already, and they also have more police officers on the streets. Yet they're both doing it for millions of dollars less than we're doing it here in Forsyth County. It can be done, and we don't need to cut your services. We don't need to cut the quality of what we're doing for you, and we won't. Once again, please pay attention to what your candidates are saying. Look at the forms we filled out. I'm not going to try to cover everything on those. Look at the forms we filled out. Ask us the hard questions. Make sure where we're standing. Thank you.
Now we're going to have closings from each of the gentlemen here. I'm just going to go in the order that I've been asking questions. You'll have 3 minutes, so we'll start with Sheriff Paxton.
I hate talking into a microphone. If somebody can't hear me, please speak up and I'll yell louder, okay? Bottom line, it's been a pleasure to be here tonight. We've all got questions we want to know, we're interested in about how government works, how the We serve you in a community, and I appreciate you being here. We've heard a lot of discussion tonight about the budget. The budget. Ladies and gentlemen, understand that the budget of the sheriff's office is basically nothing more than what it takes to pay the employees of the sheriff's office to operate the jail, which is mandated by the sheriff's office, and to pay the bills of the things we have to have. Yes, the budget in Hall County is different. The budget in Cherokee County is different. Before you start making those comparisons, be sure you are comparing apples and apples and oranges and oranges. Those entities have different ways of showing their internal accounting. There are things that are in the budget of the Cherokee Sheriff's Office that we don't do over here. There's things in our budget we do here they don't do. The same over in Hall County. So if you're going to go down that road, please do. I encourage you. Understand the difference between fact and campaign rhetoric. Go get the documents and compare apples and apples and oranges. My passion is this job. I have done it for 40 years. I've educated myself. I seek every opportunity I can to get more training and education to be sure that I'm on the cutting edge to be able to provide back to the people in this community what I'm hired to do, and that is protect you and keep you safe. And by golly, I think we do an excellent job of it. In closing, I was surprised to hear Mr. Piper use the words of one of the persons I'm sure in this room that we can all look forward to, up to. It's one of his favorite words. Yes, we can. And I don't want to hear any more of his yes, we can. Thank you.
I really say yes, we can.
Yeah, I wrote it down. You said it.
I apologize. It wasn't meant like that. In closing, I'm just going to go back to what I said in opening. Look at your candidates. Look what they're saying. Look at their records. Sheriff's been here for 11 years. Look at his record. Our budget has gone from roughly $12.5-13 million in 2001 when he took over to $37.5 million now. That's a huge increase. That drives our tax rate. That's 41%. Look at your candidates. Pay attention. Please stay involved in this process. Stay involved in the election process. Stay involved in all of your election processes. Look at your county commission races. Look at your sheriff's race. This is our government. When the constitutions were written, they were written for the government to serve us, not us serve the government. Pay attention to who you're electing. Thank you.
Again, I want to remind each of you that I'm not a career law enforcement officer. I've never arrested anyone. I do promise that I will run an office with the most ethical and moral standards that will make the citizens of Forsyth County proud. We together can reduce the budget, ensure our parents and our kids that they are safe in school, and make Forsyth County Sheriff's employees proud to come to work every day. In closing, I believe in the spirit of elections. Each of you will be able to choose who you think will be best to protect and serve this county for the next 4 years. I believe that I am that person. I want your vote.
Thank you very much, and I'd like to extend a thanks to all the candidates for coming out here and taking the time to answer questions.